Boxing champion Manny Pacquiao is considered right now the best boxer on the planet. He has 7 championships in 7 different weight divisions. But let me tell you, Pacquiao came from very humble beginnings. In fact, his close friend, Jeff De Guzman, tells me that Manny used to sleep on a cardboard box. This was when he was way younger. Now, of course, Manny is one of the richest people in the Philippines.
So Jeff, what can you tell me about how Manny Pacquiao was raised? Was he raised rich or poor?
Well, he's very poor.
Didn't even have a bed.
Yeah, when Manny was telling all the story to us, at first I thought that he was just kidding, but he was telling us the story that, you know, that box, you know, they have to cut it and convert it into that stuff.
Into a mat?
Uh-huh, a mat.
That's
and
he
then
he
sleep.
And what did he do for money? You were telling me he was selling something?
Well, he was selling bread on the street.
Really?
Was selling bread on the street to make living for himself. He works in a construction.
Really?
This is coming from Manny's mouth when he was telling the story. That's how difficult his life is. He came from a very, very poor family. He wasn't able to finish his school.
But he's very intelligent.
Yes, he's very gifted. Where can you see a fighter who can sing, who can play piano,
guitar?
Who can play guitar, play saxophone, play golf,
wow,
play tennis?
Golf is not for everybody. You need a lot of patience for
that game. Because Manny has the heart. He really has the heart. Like, he doesn't, you know, could you imagine this? I'll tell you this. 1 hour before the fight, Manny Pacquiao is still taking care of the ticket. Where can you see that kind of stuff? Huh? Can you imagine that? 1 hour before the fight. You know, he was still giving ticket for those people.
People were calling him like crazy.
Yeah.
Like, don't be selfish, give him space.
I know, but you know, could you imagine that? Manny was giving ticket 1 hour before the fight. Ticket for his concert. He was not thinking about the fight.
We're not used to seeing Manny marked up, never. This time he got a little hit. How does he respond to it?
Well, Manny, when Manny was saying the story after the fight, he said he was being criticized, never been hit by a heavier opponent. Because they said that when he fought Hatton, when he fought David Diaz,
De La Hoya,
they never scored any single punch and he never got hit. So he tried, they proved to everybody that he can absorb a punch.
He was messing with Cotto the first 2 rounds, sizing him up.
Well, Freddy was so mad on the ring, on the corner, because he was trying to disobey the game plan.
You've known Manny since 92, 7 years. What can you tell me about him over the years?
Well, he never changed, though. He's still the same guy. He's a very humble guy, very God-fearing. What can you say? He never forget those friends that, you know, even though how big he is right now, he's still the same guy.
How does he maintain that level? Because I've seen stars that are not even at his ankles go crazy when they get a little bit of following. He has such a huge following and he stays cool like a cucumber. What's his secret?
Well, the thing is, like, he never put his whatever he achieved on his head.
Really? So seven titles, seven belts, it's like it's not...
Well, he was not thinking about that. He was not thinking about that. It's like he, for him, boxing is just a career. Whatever he achieved, it's just like a business for him.
Manny dominates every time he's in the ring. Other fighters are calling me and telling me, oh, he's on something. I'm like, no, he's not. He's just good. Have you heard rumors like that?
I heard about that.
How funny is that for you to hear? Because he's good, you're blaming him?
Well, because I think it's the natural talent of Manny, you know. And, you know, Jews, I don't believe that. Because I think Manny right now is... he was taking, you know, rice for his lunch. And then he has what we call, like, in Filipino, like malunggay. Like, that's a vegetable in the Philippines that I think probably you can only find that in the Philippines, and they convert that into soup.
So Popeye has spinach. Make him strong. Pacquiao has
Malungay.
Malungay, that's his secret.
Yeah, MA, and you could tell that to Floyd Mayweather. Manny doesn't take steroids. He takes Malungay. Malungay. You could research that to your Google and look for it.
So if you guys want to be world champions like Manny Pacquiao, get on the Filipino diet. Malungay, that is the secret. His fans would want him to fight till he's 90, but he's already 30, and in sports, 30 is a little older. How many fights do you think does he have left in the tank?
Be honest with you, yeah. I think we don't want Manny to be beaten by upcoming boxer. I think for his legacy, he doesn't have to prove anything to anybody.
Absolutely not.
For my own opinion, he doesn't need Mayweather, but the boxing needs it. The boxing needs it, so the fight should happen. Because I think Pacquiao will destroy Mayweather. A blink, because Pacquiao is not gonna train in the Philippines. He'll be training here in United States, very focused on that fight, and he will prove to Mayweather that whatever he said, Pacquiao will emerge as victorious that night.
One thing I gotta tell you about Manny Pacquiao, and I hear this from everyone who knows him, is the fact that even though he's enjoying tremendous success, he's never changed. He's not gone to Hollywood, and has stayed the same humble person he's always been. In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.